Back to educator.com's AP Music Theory course. Today's lesson is on non-harmonic tones. So the objectives for this lesson, we're going to learn how to write and recognize non-harmonic tones. So we're going to look at different ones, such as passing tones, and then neighboring tones, and then we're going to see suspensions, appoggiaturas, and then finally the pedal point. So let's take a look at passing tones, and we can look at these non-harmonic tones in the context of our four-voice part writing. So I'm just going to write a couple chords in a row so we can then introduce some passing tones, or tones that are passing between different notes of a chord but that are not part of that chord. So let's look at, if we're in C major, let's start with a one chord here, E, G, C. And so let's go from this to, what about a four chord? So I'll write a four chord here. So we've got an F in the bass, and then we've got, wait, that's not going to work, is it? Let's see. C, F, A. Okay, so actually, I'm gonna have to write a third chord after this. What about a two chord? So let's see. Oh. All right, so now we have this space of a third in between in the top voice from a C to an A, which means that if I wanted to, I could perhaps fill this in with a B, and maybe this would be a half note here, and this would stay a whole note. And so the idea of a passing tone is that it fills in the space between often a third or maybe even a fourth. There could be two passing tones perhaps. And we can distinguish between passing tones that are accented and unaccented. So this would be an unaccented passing tone because this is happening, let's say, if the measures were here on every whole note. So this would be happening not on an accent. So let's put that, let's say, here's an un. accented passing tone. So again, a passing tone, and you can circle the non-harmonic tones, are moved by step and fill in the interval of a third. Let's do one more example since this one got a little strange. What about, let's be in C major, let's start on a one chord again. Let's see. C, E, G. And let's move this to a, let's see, what about a 5-6? So we can practice with a first inversion chord. So first, I know that B is going to be in the bass, and then G here, and then I want to double this G. So I'll write it down here, and now I have this voice here, the C moving to a G, is not by step, whereas all the other voices are moving by step, so that this gives me the opportunity to add in passing tones. So I can make this half note and two quarter notes, one on B, one on A, moving to G. So again, these are unaccented passing tones.